صلي وسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين الصادق الوعد الأمين. اللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، اللهم صل وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين، اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا وإمامنا وقرة أعيننا في كل وقت وفي كل حين. My dear respected brothers, quickly, Allah سبحانه وتعالى one of the greatest ever things that Allah wants us to do and Allah wants us to obey Him through is to be grateful and thankful. We as believers, my dear respected brothers, we as believers, we live in two things in this world. We live between two things. Between being grateful and thankful to Allah, that's number one. It's called manzila, rank, station, okay? And the other manzila, the other station, is being patient. Being what? Patient. And there's no third category. There is no third station. So we as believers, we live between these two. Having said that, the greatest of the two locations and two ranks are the rank of what? Being grateful to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah, He commanded us to be grateful to Him, to thank Him. How many of us not grateful to Allah? How many of us complain about what Allah has blessed us with? How many of us are not satisfied of what Allah has blessed us with? We keep complaining, Allah is giving us. We keep complaining, we want more. And we complain, we want more, and Allah is giving us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He clearly states in the Quran, He said, if you become grateful for the blessings that I'm giving you, I will give you more. I will give you more. The more you become grateful, I will give you more. وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. And if you neglect thanking me and be grateful to me, I will punish you severely. And look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, showing His mercy. Allah said, مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِنْ أَنْتُمْ شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, why would Allah punish you if you do two things? Allah said, I will never punish you. I will never punish any person or any group of people if they do two. He said, if you believe in Allah and whatever He said, and if you become grateful to Allah, Allah will never punish you. Never. That's a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah said, ما يفعل الله بعد ذلك؟ Why should I do it? Why should I punish you if you do these two? He said, that's what all I want from you. That's what I'm requiring from you. Not because I need it. Because of your own benefit. Because there's something called the Day of Judgment. So if you don't believe, if you don't fall under this category, if you don't become grateful, then I will punish you. So I'm telling you from now, Allah said, I'm telling you from now, do these two, and you say, you don't. That's all I'm asking you. It's not complicated. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the matter of the believers is so amazing. It's a bit weird. It's strange. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said this only to the believers. If something good happens to them, or him, he said him, slash her, the one, عشان sisters ما يزعلوا. طيب, if something happens to him, something good, then he will be grateful to Allah. الحمد لله اللهم لك الحمد اللهم لك الحمد لك الشكر عندي good job عندي wife عندي kids عندي parents عندي family عندي safe environment الحمد لله رب العالمين I'm satisfied الحمد لله I've got my health الحمد لله how many of us brothers I'm asking them especially the young brothers who always complain تقدموا افسحوا لإخوانكم يفسح الله لكم بارك الله فيكم افسحوا لإخوانكم يفسح الله لكم تقدموا طبعا أنا بحكي تقدموا ولا يتحرك إلا القليل. Brothers, move on, بارك الله فيكم. Move on, بارك الله فيكم. تقدموا. You know what? يفسح الله لكم. It means if you do it, Allah will make a space for you. يعني when you make a space for others, Allah will give you space. Where and how? ربك أعلم. When you make a space for others, Allah will make you space. طيب. إخواني. Brothers, you need to thank Allah. One of the ways to thank Allah is to believe with certainty, with yaqeen, that everything you live, every ni'mah, every blessing that you're living with is from Allah Azza wa Jal. And not just that, to invest your limbs in obeying Allah. Don't watch haram. Don't listen to haram. Don't walk to haram. Don't use your hands in haram. These limbs are from Allah. طب how do I thank Allah? Allah give me eyes, tamam. Allah give me tongue, tamam. Allah give me ears, beautiful. Legs, hands, heart, lungs. How do I thank Allah? Then basically, use these limbs in something to obey Allah, not to disobey Allah. How many young brothers watch haram? Watch, I don't want to say it, tamam. You know what I mean? Because there's young kids here. How many kids and how many brothers and how many sisters on social media? On social media. كله على التيك توك وعلى الفيسبوك وعلى الميك مو كذا. A girl's come, no hijab, no dress up properly. يلا, he's listening to her and he's looking fine. There's nothing wrong with it. We think it's fine. Doesn't matter, she's doing news. She's just doing something beneficial. She's presenting the news. But where's lowering the gaze? لا لا عادي. Lowering the gaze, that used at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, not anymore. Not at our time. Because the Quran is only back then, it's not for our time. Quran is not suitable for our time. According to some people who don't fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many times we, even adults, you watch, I'm talking about brothers, you watch women and girls, women on gym, doing exercise, and you watch. Subhanallah. I go, brothers, well, where are I, Habibi? Then Allah, I'm gym. Mixed gym? Oh, Allah, mixed gym. Why? Fi banat, fi. Doesn't matter, I'm not looking. Khabib Shibarak, you're not looking. Shu inti nabi, yani? Are you Yusuf, alayhi salam? Unless if you are Yusuf, go. If you are Yusuf or Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, go. If you are sinless, yani. If you are protected 100% from Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, go. Fine. But you will pay the price. You will pay the price. You will have more desires. Even if you're married, you will not be satisfied. In halal, you will not be satisfied. Why? Because you're not being thankful in your eyes. You're not being thankful. You're not using your eyes according to what Allah said. You're not using your eyes according to the maker of the eyes. If you're buying a car, you follow the instructions of the manufacturer, saying fridge, anything, any machine, you have to use it according to the manual. So use your body according to the creator, the one who made it, not according to your desires and what you think it is appropriate or inappropriate. Now, according to what Allah said, what is halal and what is haram? That's how we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'd be satisfied. My brothers, some people get involved in drugs. You know why? So they can become rich. I want to be rich. You be rich. In one hole. 1 meter, 2 meters. All the money, where they go? All the haram money, where they end up? Someone will take it. And where you end up? Ask the question by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For what? Because I just want to become rich. I just want to drive this car. I want to have that mansion. I want to buy the jet ski because my cousin has one. So I have to. I have to be fair. Allah is fair. My cousin has jet ski. I have to have jet ski. Say, طب الحرام money, in halal fine. But why in haram? لا, it's equal. ولو احنا human, we're equal. You're not thankful to Allah. You're not grateful to Allah. Are you better than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who used to sleep on hasir, on the, هذا الحصير, ايش من جزء الحصير, والله سيد ابن الحصير. Straw man. Are you better than Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم? He used to sleep on a straw mat. مش bed يعني. مش فرشي يعني. Not a normal man. Straw mat. And you can find the trace of the straw mat on his back, on his shoulder. Until Umar cried when he saw him. He said, Ya Rasulullah, the kings of Persia and the kings of Rome, they sleep comfortably on beds, huge beds. وأنت تنام على الحصير. And you sleep on the straw mat. What did he say to him? سيد يا عمر أما ترضى أن تكون لهم الدنيا ولنا الآخرة؟ Isn't it enough يا عمر that they can take the whole dunya? Take it. But إحنا لنا what? الآخرة. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. منكم من يريد الدنيا ومنكم من يريد الآخرة. Some of you Muslims, and that came down to the Sahaba, not on us, who are much, much better than us, and we cannot even compare ourselves to them. Allah said about them that some of the Sahaba, they wanted dunya. And some of the Sahaba wanted what? Al-akhirah. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, Wallahi, I never imagined that some of us wanted a dunya until Allah revealed this surah after the Battle of Uhud. So we need to wake up, ikhwani, barakallahu feekum. Obviously, we can use anything in halal, fine. Doesn't mean you can't be rich. You can't use the blessings of Allah that He blessed you with in this dunya, but with balance. And to remember that the akhirah should be our target, our aim, not the dunya. The dunya is not our aim. The dunya is not our aim. Yeah, Allah bless us with something, alhamdulillah, no problem. Use it. As long as it's in halal, you use it moderately, no problem. Use it, sahtin, halal. But the dunya is not the aim. So don't strive for it. Don't die for it. Don't work hard for it. Okay? There's no need. Do it balanced, with balance, moderately. But most importantly, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings and for all the ni'am that He blessed you with by using this ni'am in the way that He wanted you to use, not in the way that you want. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أن يجعلنا وإياكم من الشاكرين من الذاكرين الله كثيرا ونسأله سبحانه وتعالى أن يمن علينا وعليكم بالعفو والعافية في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك يا رب قريب سميع مجيب الدعوات. اللهم احفظنا واحفظ أهلينا وأولادنا من الفتن. اللهم احفظنا من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم عافنا واعف عنا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم يتقبل من إخواننا الذين حجوا بيتك الحرام، تقبل منهم وقبلهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغسلنا واغسلهم من الذنوب والخطايا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، ونقنا كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا رب إنا نسألك حج بيتك الحرام. اللهم إنا نسألك حج بيتك الحرام. اللهم ارزقنا حج بيتك الحرام بمنك وفضلك ورحمتك علينا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعلنا من القلة، اللهم اجعلنا من القلة الذين قلت فيهم وقليل من عبادي الشكور. اللهم اجعلنا من الشاكرين. اللهم اجعلنا من الشاكرين. اللهم اعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. عباد الله، ان الله تعالى ينهى عن العدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون.